You wonder why you're all here. It's because I run this little coffee shop, and I've asked you all here tonight for an open mic night. And we usually pick something and work around that. So what's a problem that has been bothering you all in today's complex, high-tech, financially distressed, hungry society?
Fat cats.
What is it?
Fat cats.
Fat cats.
Fat cats. Is that what you said? Fat cats. Fat cats.
Stella Samuelson, stand-up comedian.
You got a fat cat routine?
Oh yeah, I was in the hood. You have a name? Someone asked me, "Do you know what's cool?" And I said, "Oh, I'm fat." With a PH, with
PHAT.
Yeah. My husband, much funnier. Okay. Newt Gingrich has a cat and a wife. For the cat has 9 wives. He wishes he had 9 wives.
He would be a fat cat.
He would be. He kind of already is. Okay, I gotta go. Samuelson's my last name. Don't wear it out. I gotta go.
Ready for one more?
Sure.
Good evening.
Hey. Hey, how you doing?
Good.
Good. Good to see you all here. Hey. 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 A lot of big wigs here. Hollywood. Hollywood's good. I just made it up. You can call it.
You made me 5 cents, so.
Hey. It's good to see you. Hollywood. Big people here. A lot of big people. I call them fat cats. They got a lot of money. They're like, "Hey, look at me, I got a lot of money." And I'm like, "Hey, I don't have any money." You know? And they're like, "Hey." And I'm like, "Oh, well, here we go." Right? Am I right? Can you hear me?
Is this thing on?
And, you know, Hollywood, a lot of fat cats, but they're not actually cat lovers. They love dogs. Common misconception about Hollywood. Totally different than non-Hollywood. That's what the fat cats are talking to you. They don't know what's going on. They're like, "Hey, I got the money, and you don't have the money. You gotta do the thing." And I'm like, "Boobity boobity boo." You know what I mean?
Anybody? Okay. All right.
Oh, you got some people in the back. Hey, where are you from? All right, good. Well, hey, I'll see you again. Call me later. Okay, bye.
Bye.
Hey.
Never know who's gonna come up on this stage. You got another soul back there? Good evening, ma'am.
Hi.
Hi.
Well, hello everybody. I'm going to be doing an interpretive dance of a. My fat cat Willis. My fat cat Willis likes jerky and milk. Okay.
And now, an interpretive dance about her fat cat Willis. The gaseous cloud. Screeching time bomb. Cougar on the plow. Crunchy witchy woman. Dying of thirst. Sour. Sour milk. Look, Mom. No hand. Fat Cat Willis, I will come to get you. Hurry up and eat.
Oh my god.
Cannibalistic Catman. The exploding feline.
Rarely you see a performance like that in this coffee shop. Sonny! Sonny, are you looking for something?
Oh! Hi!
Hi! You know where you are?
No, I don't. Oh! The people. What's going on?
We're having an open mic.
Oh! An open mic! Yay! What's that?
It's where you get to tell everybody your innermost thoughts and feelings.
Oh, okay.
About fat cats.
Oh, fat cats! I like fat cats! Hello, my name is Michael Peter Fenstermacher! And I'm going to tell you about a fat cat that I know. And I like looking at fat cats. And there was Garfield. Garfield was a fat cat. And Garfield was also a president. He was a president who got assassinated by Charlie Gâteau. Like a guitar. My dad plays a guitar. He says he's like Eddie Van Halen. And one day, it was hailing outside. And I went outside. And I got a hail upside the head. And it hurt like a lot. I had a lump on my head. And the lump hurt. And so I went to the hospital. And the doctor at the hospital said that the lump had to be banded up. And I had bandages. And I looked like a mummy. And then my mummy bought me a fat cat for that. And goodbye.
I'm going to give him a chili dog next time he comes in. Anybody else out there? Come up. You can't tell. Sometimes they wait in the alley. Good evening, sir.
How you doing, Ashley?
Just fine.
Well, I'm reluctantly out of here to make some extra money. Lost all my damn money in the damn mortgage room. Oh, here, I hear you. You don't look so happy there, son. I had a big 401k in Florida. That's where I stayed. Put my money in wholesome goods. But it went awry, as it should. 'Cause it started giving up my money to Latinos. I started giving all my money to them gringos. I didn't have the right withdrawals. Money should have been liquid. But it wasn't. 'Cause all the black people want to do on the side of the road instead of work that's kicking. They took my money. Them bastards took my money. Took my money.